US President Joe Biden is preparing to welcome German Chancellor Angela Merkel in what is likely to be her final visit to the White House before she steps down later this year. COVID-19, cyberattacks and the future of Afghanistan are expected to be on the agenda. So too will be the thornier issues of China and Russia, as Nick Harper reports.
Expect a cordial, if not necessarily warm, welcome to Washington. President Biden met Chancellor Merkel most recently at the G7 summit in the UK last month. Before that, as Vice President, Mr. Biden visited Germany for the Munich Security Conference, an event he also participated in virtually this year. But despite their past, present challenges may make this meeting a little more awkward.
Germany is still in the mood of Russia and China can be our business partners. We don't have to like them, but if we find them commercially useful to us, we'll do business with them. That is no longer the United States policy.
The White House has opposed the Nord Stream 2 project, an undersea pipeline which will soon transport Russian gas to Germany. President Biden argues the $11 billion deal makes its EU ally too reliant on Moscow. Chancellor Merkel was also a leading voice in securing the EU-China investment deal, to the displeasure of the Biden administration. It's an area of collaboration with China, when the White House is more determined to drive competition. If ratified, it would create closer economic ties by giving European companies better access to China. As such, the White House may look for traction on other China-related issues.
You can definitely expect Joe Biden himself and the rest of his administration to push Merkel a little bit more on democratic values, on sovereign rights, on the Uyghur situation in Xinjiang, on Hong Kong's freedoms and democracy, on what China is doing in the South China Sea, that Merkel has been very reluctant to openly condemn this.
Congratulations on winning, and by the way,
the Biden administration will also use the visit to continue repairing relations after 4 years of frayed ties under President Trump. The former president was particularly critical of Germany's underfunding of NATO. Agreements at this meeting, though, could still be possible, potentially in tackling cyberattacks and easing US-Germany COVID-19 travel restrictions, despite the two leaders' differences of opinion.
These are not ideological barriers. These are sort of the pragmatic parts of governing that two skilled leaders are able to address, and they know how to work with each other, not to insult, not to belittle, not to berate, but to find ways to cooperate in their own self-interest and, as importantly, in their mutual interest.
Merkel's tenure has been a stabilising force in German politics for almost 16 years. This White House meeting may have rockier moments, but their different strategies on China and Russia are unlikely to be enough to upset relations on this farewell visit. Nick Harper, CNA, Washington.